Hello, this is Nikki in Niagara coming to you from Niagara Falls, Canada. Today is the day that I show you my finished pages, and these are the pages that I did in January of 2024. Please excuse my voice. I have had a bad sinus cold for the last 5 or so days, so I still sound a bit nasally. So first of all, this is my first book by Prime Maximus, I believe. Maximus Prime. I should know that. Maximus Prime. It's called Mystery Mosaic, Color by Number, and the issue is Love Season. And this is the page that I did. Now, these are a bit different than our usual. They're 3x3 squares. And they're done from photographs, so when you look at them with your naked eye, they look really pixelated. You need to look at them from far away or on the camera, and they look really realistic that way. I don't think I really had much fun doing it because it's not block coloring like the others. It's like your color that you're doing is like all over it, you know. You might just have a couple here, and you know, then you have big spaces of it, but there's never any like full blocks to color, so it took a long time to do this, and I'm not sure it was worth the effort. But I'm pleased with the way the picture came out. Like on camera, it looks great. And I have Mindful Mandalas, the December issue. No. Yes, the December issue. Winter Warmers. I wish they would put the date on these things. So I did one last month, and I did the second one this month. These are random colors, and I really enjoyed this one. We got the flicker. Now, somebody asked me, and I don't know if I ever answered them, what I use for my glitter gel pens. I'm using 3 brands at the moment. I'm using, I have to read this one because it's hard to say. Lan Ren Wing, Tan Mitt, and Chromatech. I don't like the Chromatechs very much. The Tan Mitts are the second favorite, and my favorite are the Lan Ren Wing. So there you go. Then I did a couple out of Whimsical Winter Wonderland by Molly Harrison. I have this one here, which I used. What did I use? Lyra Giants and Marco Squares. So some obscure colors there. And I used some glitter watercolor as well. That's just cheap stuff from Timu. And this one here, I used Castle Art Gold, and again, the silver is, pretty sure that's the Timu paint, and I have Ranger Stickles Gel on the wings. Couple of pictures out of Mine Winter Spazzer Gang, or My Winter Walk by Rita Berman. Did this one here with the drawing pencils and the Cohen Newer. They didn't really go together well, those two pencils, but I had committed, so I had to finish with them. I don't know, I'm not too crazy about them. I've got some gel pen on. Is that gel pen? No, that's just some marker that I've done those with. Used paint pen. And then this is the other one I did. This one I used Miscellaneous Watercolor Pencils. I have a pencil case that, it's not full, but it's got quite a lot in it that's of just miscellaneous watercolors that I've happened upon during the years that aren't complete sets, and I've just bunched them all together. And this is what I've come out with here. on this one. I really like this one. Did Winter Mystery Pixel by Pixelmania. This one is color by Number Seasons. So these are 4x4 squares, so they're more pixely than the 3x3s, but they look nice from afar again. That one. And this one. And with this one, my browns kept running out. So I've got a different color for this arm, this arm. His head and body and his back are all different browns. I couldn't keep one going long enough, but it looks all right. Could look worse. Now, this did not work out the way I wanted it to at all. I had a major background fail. So, oh, this is Winter Wonderland by Paper and Cloth Studio. Don't believe there is an actual artist. No, there's no named artist. Oh, if I remember right, this is the one that says on the back, thanks to Carol, Nancy, so-and-so. Yeah, Carly Lewis, Louise, Beck, and Gemma. Talk about a plug, eh? So anyways, I colored this one using this color palette right here. And as you can tell on this page, I really liked my coloring. I thought it looked great. And then I went to put on a background, and I can't even remember what I did. But I started up here, and it was just an absolute mess, and it was dark. That's the problem. Now, there's no way I can use black acrylic on this because there's all these little bits and things like this, see-through. So I just covered it up the best I could using some sort of water-soluble medium. I have no idea what it is, but it's a mess. Yeah, I had to gesso, use white gesso to go over the dark, and then, yeah. I didn't even write down what pencils I used for this, so I figured, well, let's not. I could have made this the same and hated both sides, but I just decided to use something light on this side, so I used, is that still coming off? Hard to tell. Oh, I don't think so. I used fixative on this anyways. That's pan pastel in the background. I don't know if it shows up too well. It's a light green. I like this book, though, a lot. Then, the book that my Facebook group has chosen to do this year as our full color buddy color, A Million Little Monsters by Lulu Mayo. You can join me in my Facebook group where the link is down below at the bottom of my description, or you can join along here on YouTube or on Instagram using the hashtag Nikki and the Little Monsters. All one word. So we had to do 6 pages this month. And let's see, I've put some of my color palette sheets in here. Wait, I need that. So, I used this color palette, number 387. These are the color cubes by Sarah. So, what? So why can't I? I want to say Sarah Jessica Parker. Sarah Renee. I can't remember her name. Is it on here? No. Sarah Renee Clark? So anyways, I did this, and I used the Polychromos for this page, and I used some glitter for the middle there. The background is just paint pen. With these two. Using the Brute Fooner Skin. They make a very interesting color palette. I really like it. So that was just the Brute Fooner Skin pencils. They're very nice. They're like the round barrels. They work like the round barrels, the black barrels maybe, the 180 set. I don't know what people call it. Looks like I've got something on there. What's that? I don't even know what that is. Didn't come from here. It didn't come through there. What the heck is that? Wonder if it'll erase. Then this was our group color. Each month there's some kind of challenge or communal thing to do, and this was a buddy color page for everybody to color this one page, and then whatever other pages they wanted to color. Then I did these two here. This page first over here, I used the luminance, and I love the way it turned out. This is, teal is my absolute favorite color, and I just love working different color combinations with teal. And these pencils are beautiful on this paper. And then for this one, I used watercolors. I used the Montmartre and the Woodless and the Prisma watercolors. On this one, the Prisma watercolors are very nice. They have a lot of good pigment, but there's only 36 colors, so I needed to add another set. The Montmartre, or small set, just to give me enough colors to work with this. And those are my 6 pages that I did this month for the group buddy color. So come along and join us, join the group, join the hashtag, whichever way you prefer. And we have Matchstick Mouse, a winter coloring book. Did this one, and I used the Laurentians and along with one Polly and 2 Dixons. Those are just, the Dixons are just something from that my sister passed along in one of my boxes. There's a few odd pencils. But yeah, the Laurentians work really nice. I don't have a full set, otherwise I could use them just. So there is some Ranger Stickles Gel on there. Let's see, I had it for a minute. Come on, where do you wanna hit the light? Come on, there, a little bit. It is quite a bit shiny, but it's just not gonna hit. This one was done with watercolors, the Kohinoor Mondalus. And again, I've got the Ranger Stickles Gel on the snow. Then we have the January Mindful Mandalas, I believe. Restful Winter, anyways. So these have pictures in them, a lot of them, which I'm not too crazy about. So this one I don't like. But did you know that polar bears are really yellow and not white? Yeah, probably. And this one. The shine isn't working too well on here, but there are 2 gel pens in there. Yeah, not too crazy about those. So that was my winter coloring for the month, and then I went back to these that I was working on in November and prior to that, doing 2 pages a month out of these books. So these are all Color by Numbers by A.J. Quinnell, or Eclipse Art. This is the very first book that they ever came out with, and the very first edition of it, Sea Life. This is a circulism book. So I did this one. This was very hard to tell what it was until I was practically done. And this one here. Very rainbow, that one. Sorry for the squeaks of my chair, but that's just the way it is. So this one is a circulism book, and it's The Forest. This was actually their second book. So we've got this one. And some really huge circles. I don't think they do them like that anymore. And this one is pretty cool. So we have an art, color art one. This one is scenery. These are all sideways, I believe. That one, and this one. These are a lot of fun. I like this book. another color art book. This one is Wander. These are sideways as well. Got this one. And this one. So I think each of these represents a different country. I don't know what that first one was, but this one's obviously Australia. Then a Circulism one, a Sealy Zuri. Love that. I don't know. This is African animals, I believe. I have no idea what that is. That's not the one I did. This one is giraffes, baby giraffes. I really like that one. Echidna. So this has something to do with Australia. The pictures, I believe, are kind of like scenery mostly, or trees, which, well, I guess that's scenery, isn't it? So there's that one. And this one. Now, just so you know, these books don't really conform to it because these are early books that I bought by the publisher. But now I have a set way that I go about these books, is that if it is a Circulism book, I buy the standard paper because they look fine done in anything. But for the color art series, like that scenery one, I buy the special paper and use alcohol markers on those, and then they look the nicest. So this one is, it's just called Australia. So this is some kind of Australian mouse or kangaroo family. I wish they would tell you what the pictures were. Maybe at the back, a list of them. I like this one. This one was kind of a pain to do, though. Getting all the right numbers down here. But yeah, it's quite bright and vibrant. That's what I like about their books. I just love vibrant colors. So then I worked in the Flying Color Volume 13 magazine. And I've torn a lot of pages out of this because I just kept the... After a while, there was a lot of pictures in here, and I just like the pattern pages. So I tore out all the pages that weren't pattern pages. So I did this one, which I don't like. And then I did this one, which I really like. These are random colors, and it's like I put that together perfectly. And I think I only have two more pages to go in here. Or is it a couple more? One. Yeah, I only have two more to go. Could somebody tell me if they still make these penny press coloring books? Because none of the stores in my town have them. So I don't know. This is from 2013, so that's not going to help us. So what I'm showing you now are books that I'm going to be working in every month, the ones I just showed you, and continuing on. So this is Daria Kekersoy's first book, Fantasy Fairy Portraits. I'm working on doing two in here. We've got Eve. This is actually a Christmas picture, but I got it done in time. January's fine. It's not overly Christmassy. And Miss Little Steampunk. So I don't know if you can see it or not, but I put glossy accents on the goggles, and the owl has a monocle, and I put it on that too. There should be just a bit of shine, but on the page they're 3D. Relaxing Color Mandala by Sun Life Drawing. I'm trying to do three a month in here and get this book finished. But this one, these are all random colors. Remember, I always do mandalas with random colors. That's not too bad. I didn't like the colors, but it's not too bad. Same with this one. I didn't like doing it, though, because I don't like ones that have white space in them, and there's just too much white space to color it in. I think it looks better this way. And this one, again, looks almost monochromatic. So I'm more than halfway through that. Tool month out of the steampunk, 50 steampunk mandalas by Sachem Sachdeva. This is not the color by number edition. So this was the last of the animal mandalas that I've been doing in a row here. So I didn't enjoy doing this one very much. Then back to these ones. These are the ones that I really like that are all just cogs and wheels and parts. Yeah, so I enjoyed that one. And finally, at the end of the month, my sister and I did a buddy color. She picked what we would do, and we went back in time to Magical Jungle by Joanna Basford. And we colored this page right here. So I used Spearer Farben, and I did not enjoy them on this paper. I found they kind of slid, and they didn't grip the paper like I like paper to be gripped, and the blending was a bit difficult. But I persevered since I'd started, and you know how it goes. So the background is watercolor ink, and it went through a bit like that, but I'm not gonna worry about that. It's easily fixed. Just use a dark color on the other side or the same stuff. And I use Gansy Tambi down here for the earth. Otherwise, it's just straight pencil. Yeah, and I enjoyed doing that. I'm going to be working in my Joanna Basford books in the next little while. Do a picture in every one that I have, I think, is what I'll do. So that's that one done, and that's the end of the books. So thank you so much for joining me and allowing me to share with you. I hope you enjoyed your time with me looking at my pictures. And if there's any requests, just ask. I'm here. So until next time. Bye-bye.